Welcome to module 25, subspaces. So starting with a topological space, we want to define what is the meaning of subspaces of this topological space. Once again, we go back to the metric spaces for motivation. Given a subset Y of a metric space X, D, what did we do? We merely took D prime to be the restriction of D on X cross X. That was a metric on Y cross Y. Y, you know, restricted to Y cross Y, the metric will be on Y. Even before that, we had a nonlinear space. You take a vector subspace this time and then restrict the norm. That gives you a subspace which is a norm linear subspace. Here, what do we want to do? There are no functions here to restrict. On the other hand, go back to the topology given by a metric. The bases were open balls. Okay. The open balls with respect to D prime, they will be inside the subspace Y, but the definition will be exactly same. And therefore, what happens is this BRXD prime, set of all Y inside Y, such that D prime of XY less than R, same thing as D of XY less than R, right? X and Y are points of Y, that's the difference. But then this is nothing but BR of XD intersection with Y. Okay, only thing is you have to start with X and Y inside capital Y here. All right. So take a basic element here in the larger topology, larger space, intersect it with the subspace, subset. Those will form a basic elements for the subspace topology. The vector the metric subspace topology. If that works fine, then that should be the definition in the general case. And we will check that that is precisely what works properly, and that gives you a definition here. Okay, so BR of YD prime is BR of YD intersection with Y for every point inside Y. So take a topological space and a subset Y of X. We make Y into a topological space by taking tau Y equal to all those U such that U is in tau intersected with Y. So I am directly defining this way, and I verify that this tau Y itself verifies the topology, definition for topology, conditions for topology. Clearly, members of tau Y will cover the whole of Y. They won't cover the whole of X because they are all inside Y. Okay. And empty set will belong to that. Those things are easy. Even if you don't check it, Fi and Au, if you check, that's enough. Finite intersection of say u1 intersection y, u2 intersection y, u3 intersection y is nothing but u1 intersection, u2 intersection, u3 intersection y. But intersection of u1, u2, u3, etc. is inside tau. Therefore, this will be inside tau y. Similarly for the union. Okay, so checking that this is topology is just elementary set theory. So this is called the subspace topology on Y. Okay. So we will have lot of instances wherein we have to use subspace topology. Each time what we do is take an open subset in Y that will look like U intersection Y, where U is open inside X. So you have to keep on writing this. Okay. So we will not decorate tau and tau y and so on. We just say y is a subspace of x, and do not mention the two topologies tau and tau y, which are behind the scene. But if there are different topologies, then we have to mention this. Okay. In the beginning, at least, we shall mention it till we get used to this concept for a few time till you get. The inclusion map is one of the fundamental maps here between a subspace, subset, and the given set, right? Luckily, this is a continuous map. Okay. Indeed, more generally, take any continuous function from X to Z, okay, restrict it to Y. Okay, the restricted function. Original function is continuous, would imply the restricted function is continuous. Here, X to X identity map is continuous. Restriction map is what? Inclusion map. Okay. Suppose you have proved the inclusion map is continuous. Inclusion from Y to X followed by F is nothing but a restriction. Right? Composite of two continuous function is continuous. So that will verify this one. If you verify this one continuous, verification of this one follows. If you have verified this one, that follows. Right? The verification of any one of them is as easy as anything else. Why start with an open set here? Take the inverse image that is open. To come to Y, what is F inverse of an open subset here when you take the restriction map? It is just take the full inverse image and then take the intersect it with the subset Y. That's all. Okay. So that verifies this one. Now the process of taking this induced topology, whatever we have, subspace topology, okay. Subspace topology is also called induced topology, is a transitive operation in the following sense. Take a subset Y and another subset of Y, let's say Z. Z contains a Y, contains an X. Then you can have induced topology on Z, okay, as a subspace of Y. You can have induced topology of Z as a directly subset of X. Okay. So Y is a subspace of X, Z is a subspace of Y. So that is like this is related to this, is related to this. That is a process. Okay. It's same thing as directly Z is a subspace of X. That is the meaning of transitivity. Okay. The induced topology on Z. By the topology on Y, which itself is induced from X, the same as that induced directly from X. This is a direct consequence of the fact that I have to finally take a subset of X here, A, intersect it with Z, which is same thing as one step, A intersection Y first, and then taking A intersection Y intersection Z. Okay, this is true for all subsets of X. So in particular, when you have open subset, you get. Thus, for any Z contained in Phi Y, contains the X, what we have is the tau Z is tau Y Z. So tau restricted to Z is same thing as tau restricted to Y, restricted further to Z. In general, an open set in a subspace in the subspace Y need not be open in X. However, if Y itself is open in X, then it's easily seen that every open set in Y is open in X as well. Why? Because Every open set in Y by definition is U intersection Y, where U is open in X. But if you start with Y as open, U intersection Y will be open in X. So that is a simple reason here. Okay. Similarly, a closed subset in the subspace Y need not be closed subset of X again. If Y itself is closed, then by taking complementations, every closed subset of Y will be closed in X also. Okay. So closed will be closed, that is transitivity. Open, that is open, that is also transitivity. So taking subspace is very strongly transitivity relation, it's here. All right. The last remark implicitly warns us that we need to re-examine various concepts such as closed, interior, limit points, boundary points afresh in the context of subspaces. What is the last remark? A subset which is open inside Y in general may not be open inside X. If you want to make it open always, then you have to take Y as open. But then closed subspace may not be accurate. Now suppose Y is open inside X, but now you take a closed subset of Y, that may not be open inside X. So every time you are taking interior, limits, boundary, and so on, you have to be extremely cautious about what is going on. Okay, so you have to freshly check whether the old definition for Y itself, whether something is working or not. All right, so let us have some elaborate notation here and study the closure properties and interior properties and so on for a while in the light of this definition, subspace topology. For any subset A of Y, let us denote the closure of Y with respect to tau Y, everything happening inside tau, with CL YA. Okay, all that because we are worried that we are having an ambient thing. Okay, the language of the larger space, the country, has to be respected here. It is like X is the country and Y is a state inside that. Okay. So closure of Y inside A is by definition with respect to everything happening inside Y is tau Y. And the same with respect to X, namely by the old notation, closure of A. This will be with respect to X now for the whole thing. So there we are using simpler notation. Of course, we could have closure of A with respect to X also here. That is not necessary. If there is one more, say in between Z and so on, then we may have to write that Z also here and so on, right? the ambient, the space, the original space X, the mother space X, we will keep the old notation. Similarly, interior of Y in A will denote the interior of A with respect to the topology tau Y. If you don't write this Y, then it will be interior of this one as a subset of X in the topology of X. Is the notation clear? This notation will be used only when there is a confusion, when there are two different subspaces are involved, interior of what, where are you taking it? Okay. So this is the lemma. Start with a subset A of Y. Okay. All of them inside X, that is the assumption already. A is closed in the subspace Y if and only if A is equal to B intersection Y for some closed subset B of X. This was not the definition for us. Okay, something is a closed subspace of Y if and only if the complement of A in Y is open in Y. from that I want to get this thing, namely directly coming from x. What I have to do? Take a closed subset of x, intersect it with y. But just like you have defined open sets, you could have defined closed sets also. That is the gist of this property one. The second property says the closure of A with respect to Y is just the closure of A intersected with Y, if Y is closed. Okay? Sorry, this is for Y. And if Y is closed, then closure of A is actually closure of A with respect to Y is actually closure of A. There's no need to take the intersection. In particular, a closed subset of a closed subspace is closed. Why I am taking in particular? Suppose Y is closed, then when you take A is closed inside Y, this closure of YA will be A. Okay, that means A is equal to closure of A, that means that A is closed in X. So this part follows. So we have to show this part, namely closure YA is equal to closure Y intersection Y, closure of A intersection Y, and if Y is closed, then this is. Okay, let us prove these things. By definition, A is closed in Y if and only if Y minus A is open in Y, right? That implies, by definition, that there is an open set U in X such that Y minus A is U intersection Y. Now, put B equal to X minus U. X minus U is a closed subset of X. And all that you have to check is now A is B intersection Y. Okay, so set theoretic thing you have to verify. All right, B is X minus U. Okay, so something intersection with Y means it must be first of all point of X. It is not in Y, but not in U, but in Y. Okay. Second part, take X as a closure point of A in the topology Y. Now, given an open subset U of X, by definition, okay, of tau Y, U intersection Y is open. Now, what is the closure point? Closure point means, now X will be inside U intersection Y. Okay, first of all, so U intersection Y is a neighborhood of X inside Y, right? Why X is into U intersection Y? Because X is a point of A of Y itself, because it is in this topology. So X is already inside Y. Okay. So take a point X inside U, X inside U, it will be automatically inside U intersection Y. Therefore, U intersection Y intersection A is non-empty. Okay. Why? Because it is the closure of this. Every open subset containing X will intersect A. That is the meaning of this. But then this intersection is non-empty means U intersection A is non-empty. All right. Therefore, X is the closure of A. I put Y because I started with X as a point of Y. So closure of A with respect to Y is contained inside closure of A intersection Y. Now I take the other way inclusion. Start with a point here, closure of A intersection Y. Take any neighborhood V of X in Y. Okay. In Y, something is a neighborhood means what? By the definition of tau I, you have a neighborhood U of X in X such that V is U intersection Y. All right. Now it is a closure point in the original topology X. Therefore, U intersection A is non-empty. But what is V intersection A? It is U intersection Y intersection A, right? But that is same thing as U intersection A, right? Because A is a subspace of Y. So this Y intersection A is just superfluous. It is same thing as A. Therefore, X is in the closure of A. So we have proved the equality. All that you have to do is take the closure of A inside the larger space and then take only points of Y, intersect with Y. That will give you the relative closure, closure of A with respect to the smaller space Y. Now suppose Y is closed in X. A is already inside Y, by the way, all right? So we know that closure of A will be contained inside Y, right? Because closure of A is contained closure of Y, but closure of Y is Y. Therefore, closure of A is equal to closure of A intersection Y, because it's already inside Y. But by definition, we now just shown by part one is equal to the closure of A with respect to Y. Okay, this is this easier part. Here we have to completely go through the definitions on both ways. Okay, so the whole idea is if you have done it now, then you will remember it, then you don't have to do it every time whenever you meet that occasion. Now, similarly for interiors, okay, let X be a topological space, Y be a subspace of X. If Y is open in X, then every open set in Y is open in X also. This we have already commented, so I have put it here as a reference. Second part is more important. For any subset A of Y, interior of Y, interior of A with respect to Y, contains the intersection of interior of A with Y. So here there is no equality. See, if Y is open, then the two are equal. Okay, there is no need to take intersection. In particular, an open subset of an open subspace is open. Okay. So we have to verify this, namely, interior of A with respect to Y contains interior of A intersection Y. Okay. Actually, many times this part, the right hand part, may be empty. But this part may not be empty. Lots of examples are there like that. Okay. So let's come to this one. By the very definition, A contained inside Y is open in Y if there is an open subset U such that A equal to U intersection Y. Since Y is open, the intersection is open. This is the first part. I have repeated it. The second part, start with a point in the interior of A, but this point is already inside Y, intersection with Y I have taken. So we have a neighborhood, open neighborhood U of X such that X inside X such that U is contained inside A. Okay. What is this one? Interior of A itself is a neighborhood, nothing else. See, interior of A is an open subset of X, but it's contained inside A. And X belongs to, that means X belongs to U, and U is a neighborhood of F, right? And it's contained there. But then U will be also contained inside Y because A is a subspace of X, subspace of Y. A is a subspace of Y, right? Subspace of Y, that is our assumption. Okay. If an open subset of X is already contained inside Y, that will be automatically open inside Y because I have to intersect it with Y, you get the same U. And hence, U intersection Y is U, is a neighborhood of open neighborhood of X in Y. If you have found an open neighborhood of a point, that point must be in the interior, right? So it is in the interior of A with respect to Y. So the first part we have proved, namely the interior intersection with Y is contained in the interior A with respect to Y. Okay, there is no equality here. Now we go to the second part, namely, suppose Y is an open subset. A is contained inside Y, that is given. Okay, so interior of A is contained inside interior of Y by the interior operator as its property, but interior of Y is Y. Right? So all these things happening inside X. Therefore, interior of A is contained in interior of A intersection Y. But this we have proved as is contained in the interior of A with respect to Y. Okay. Interior of A with respect to Y is open in Y. So one way we have proved this is this part is contained inside here. Interior of A is open in Y, right? Every interior A with respect to any topology is open in that. Okay. Therefore, it follows that interior YA is open in X itself. Because Y is open in X. So it's the first part. Since it is a subset of A, it follows that interior A with respect to Y is contained in the interior of A. Right? After all, this is a subset of, always a subset of A. Now we have what? It is an open subset, therefore it's contained inside the interior of A. Because interior of A is the maximal open subset, largest open subset contained in A. Remember that. Okay, so therefore there is an equality here. This way equality, and this is the other way inclusion. All right. So I have already told you interior, how interior can fail to be equality can hope. So we will have lots of such examples. Let us look at R cross 0 contained inside R2. Let us take R2 as X, R cross 0 as Y. Okay. Now take the usual topology in R2. Now the mapping F from R going to R2 given by X, F, 0. It's a continuous injection, right? It's continuous and it's injection. With its image, what is the image of this map? It is the fill Y, namely R cross 0. Okay. So this is how we think of the real line R as a subspace of R2. This is one standard way, right? So it's equal to the image Y. With the subspace topology on Y, take subspace topology. What is subspace topology? Everything you have to take open subsets in R2 and intersect with R cross 0. Then F inverse from Y to R is also continuous. Why? Because this map is nothing but the restriction of the coordinate function X comma Y going to X. So that is the inverse image of this X going to X comma 0. It comes back to X only on X cross 0. So if we have taken the whole space X comma Y, you take the first coordinate, that is the restricted to X cross 0, it will be again that. Being a restriction of a continuous function, this function F inverse is continuous. Therefore, F defines a homeomorphism of R with respect to Y. Okay? The same argument and conclusion hold for 0 cross R also. There is nothing very special about the first coordinate being 0 or the second coordinate being 0. Identical conclusions are identical, arguments are there. All that you have to do is 0, comma, y, you can write it as, instead of y, you can write, instead of x, you can write it as y, that's all. And then y going to 0, comma, y. More generally, with the subspace topology, you can take any line given by an equation, ax plus by plus c equal to 0, to make it a nice line as such, not just the whole space or something. All that I have to assume that this vector AB is not 0, is homeomorphic to R under the mapping, depends upon which coordinate A or B is not 0. AB not equal to 0 means either A is not equal to 0 or B not equal to 0. Maybe both of them are not equal to 0. That is also allowed. But you don't know which one is not 0. So accordingly, you can choose two different maps. Both of them may work if A and B are not 0. What is this? First coordinate is, it is the graph of this function. Okay, y equal to minus at plus c, this y coordinate. T going t comma, this is something ft. You have to solve for y in this equation, that's all. Here, you solve for x in terms of y here. So I am, instead of y, I am writing t here. So t goes to t here, second coordinate is y. This is your x coordinate. Okay. So this is elementary, test standard stuff. You are solving for y in terms of x, or x in terms of y. Of course, that needs either a is not equal to 0 or b not equal to 0. That condition has to be there. According as b not equal to 0 or a not equal to 0, you have tried. Notice that all these examples are closed subspaces of R2. Okay, so therefore, if you take a closed subspace of R, then their image inside this line as a subspace of R2, it will be closed. But open, no chance. Okay. So under this, I am asking you somewhat vague question here, so that I want you to think about this. So whole idea here is, I have put, subspaces which they occur with the familiar spaces. See, this is R cross 0, this is 0 cross R, this is any line. They are all homeomorphic to R. Okay? They are all homeomorphic to R. So this is the first example. So now come to second example. Take X tau be any topological space. Take any two points, A and B, distinct points. Look at the subspace topology on singleton A and singleton B. Exist topological space, okay? So singleton A is a subspace, subset, so there is a topology on it. Singleton B, there is a topology on it. Question is, what can you say about these two topological spaces? Okay, separately, and together also, what can you say? Okay. Second, now consider a special case when X is the Sierpinski space with 0, 1. Okay. Any A comma B will do, two distinct points. But we have denoted 0 and 1, with 1 being the Sierpinski point, which just means that the only open set containing 1 is the whole space 0. Singleton 0 is open. Therefore, singleton 1 is closed, but singleton 1 is not open. That is the meaning of Sierpinski point 1. You know that 0 is open in X, whereas 1 is not open. Okay. See, here I didn't get any subspace which is open subspace. They are all closed subspaces and they are all homeomorphic. So I want to give an easy example wherein subspaces Okay, one is a closed substrate, another is not a closed substrate, or one is open, other is not open. What can you say about the two topologies was the first question. Here, whatever you have said there, combine it with this special case here, what do you conclude? Okay, so come up with some answer and then check it with your tutors. Okay, that is the game you have to do. So let us stop here. There will be many examples, many more new things coming up and so on next time. In next time, we will have to do union of spaces from smaller things to larger things. Okay? Thank you.